Thank you, chairperson. My name is Toshiyuki Fujita from Kogakuin University. Today, I'd like to talk about tweet classification using conversational relationships. First of all, the background. When a disaster occurs, such as an earthquake or a typhoon, the media to get information about the disaster are news, newspapers, and Twitter as a kind of microblogging. If you want to know what information is being exchanged between people, Twitter is a good source of information. When you use Twitter, you can get tweets containing the keyword by searching with the keyword. But we can't get tweets that don't contain keywords. To avoid this problem, we need a method that classifies tweets into clusters directly. As an example of the method, LDA is used for semantic cluster extraction in conversational studies. But it will be necessary to take countermeasures on microblogging due to the difficulty of short sentences. In previous research, there's a topic answer model and Twitter LDA model. In particular, the topic answer model treats tweets posted by one user as one document. However, even tweets within a single user, the topic is likely to change over time. By contrast, in a conversation, tweets seem to be differing to the same topic. For example, in response to A's tweets, typhoon, B said at A, it's raining hard. Therefore, this study will use conversations that are expected to stay on the same topic. Based on the LDA model, built as one conversation is one document. We aim to obtain a set of documents that differ to the disaster. As a comparative method, we introduce a cluster merge model of clustering after K-means clustering, followed by cluster merging by conversational relationships. Our purpose is to extract disaster-related tweets precisely from full tweets. We can define this as a program that classifies clusters as disaster-related or not disaster-related. The traditional methods of text analysis are the LDA topic model and the K-means clustering algorithm. Tweet merge model based on the LDA topic model and the K-means. The proposed method gets a tweet as input and clusters as output. And for each cluster, words that together describe the summary of tweets in the cluster. This word set is called the summary word set. This summary word set is used by the user to determine whether tweets in a cluster is referring to a disaster or not. For example, in clusters A and B, there are groups of words related to disasters, such as hurt and rain. In contrast, there are words in clusters C and D that do not seem to be related to the disaster. By looking at this summary word set, users can decide that they can get only the group of tweets mentioning the disaster if they choose clusters A and B. Next, I will explain the flow of the purpose method. First, to use a conversation, we get a set of tweets that contains a conversation. In the tweet merged model, the conversation is extracted in part 2 to obtain a set of documents consisting of one conversation is one document. A naive model uses a document set consisting of one tweet is one document. Next, we build an LDA topic model from a set of documents. We then clustering the tweets using k-means. Part 4, for each cluster, we obtain a set of words that represent the characteristic of the cluster. Now, let's take a closer look at each process. I will explain how to get tweets. First, we obtain a tweet set using Streaming API that returns a small random sample of all public status via a stream on Twitter. Next, we specify a reply property as a query to the lookup API, which can derive tweets by a specified tweet ID. This tweet set consists of the chased replied tweets. Extract a conversation from tweets that contains a conversation. In a stream of replies, a tweet that replied to another tweet is called a reply tweet. And the default to tweet is the reply is called the original tweet. A series of chained reply tweets is called a conversation. We will take one conversation as one document. In this case, tweets that do not have a reply relationship are excluded. For LDA input documents, we use only nouns determined to be nouns by MegaP, a Japanese morphological analyzer. We also excluded unnecessary words that appear to a list of stop words defined by ThreadSlip and a unique list defined by us. So symbol, pictograms, and so on. Also, the tweet makes a back of words and the TF-IDF square vector is assigned as a future vector of the tweet. Part 4, documents are clustered on the topic space using the k-means method. The summary word set of a cluster is built with the top few words of the score for each word in the target tweet set. The score of the word W is defined as equation in this yellow shaded area. In this section, I'm going to talk about the evolution of the purpose method. We evaluated the purpose method compared with the naive model as used in the conversational text classification method in terms of classification accuracy. We evaluated the method's classification accuracy by the z-score of the binomial test to see whether disaster mentioning tweets are dominant in each cluster in each method or not. The comparative method is the naive model and the cluster merged model. Now let me explain the comparative methods. The naive model is simply a set of documents at the time of input to LDA. One tweet is one document. In the cluster merge model, in addition to naive model, after the k-means clustering step, clusters with similar conversations are merged. First, at the initial clustering with k-means, we assigned the number of clusters large k to be larger than the commonly used number of clusters. Keeping in mind the cluster merging process described below. Next, when there is a reply related tweet across clusters, this method merges a reply tweet and an original tweet clusters. In the example shown on the slide, cluster Q is the cluster to which the original tweet belongs. Cluster P is the cluster to which the reply tweet belongs. We merge those two clusters and let cluster Q and P be cluster Q dash. This section explains the tweets used in the experiment. The tweets set from the first 60 minutes of time span are used for each target disaster. Conversations up to 60 minutes before the disaster occurred were searched for. This is about the experimental requirement. We use a morphological analyzer called MakeUp for morphological analysis of Japanese text. We use the Genshin library to implement LDA topic model and k-means. This section explains the evolution method. In this experiment, the z-score in the binomial test is used as a measure of the accuracy of the cluster classification. The definition of the z-score is shown in the yellow background of the slide. Let the null hypothesis be a random selection and let the alternative hypothesis be a non-random sampling. We assume that the higher the absolute value of the z-score, the more accurately the cluster K is classified and the higher the classification accuracy. We will now explain how to create a correct dataset. Three male university students in their 20s were asked to label their work. The labels was determined by the majority vote. For each disaster, we get a document consisting of one document is tweet and one document is conversation. For each document, 500 tweets were randomly selected. In this case, the selection is limited to documents of 1,000 words or less. The reason for this is to reduce the burden on the evaluator. The similarity between the labels determined by the majority vote and the labels determined by each evaluator was calculated using Cohen-Kappa coefficient, following the interpretation by Landis and Koch. The results are in almost perfect agreement. Also, the conditions were ambiguous as to whether or not referred to disaster. The results shows no significant difference between the majority vote and the labeling by each person. In this slide, I will show you the results of an experiment focusing on classification accuracy. If the z-score is between minus 1.96 and 1.96, we can say that the null hypothesis is not rejected and the result is no different from random sampling. If the z-score is height in the possible direction, the cluster is a group of documents that refer more to disasters, and if it is height in the negative direction, that cluster is a group of documents that do not refer more to disasters. In the case of Typhoon Hagibis, the number of clusters in which the null hypothesis could be rejected was heightened in the ZMERGE model than in the other two models. Next, we focus on the classification accuracy by the slide of the absolute value of a simple Z-score. In the case of Typhoon Hercules, the ZMERGE model has more clusters with a higher absolute Z-score than the other two models. In particular, more clusters with higher absolute Z-score were obtained in the two clusters with a large number of documents, such as clusters 2 and 3, than in the results in the other two models. The ZMERGE model seems to have achieved a higher classification accuracy than the other two models for Typhoon Hercules. So, even in clusters with high classification accuracy where the null hypothesis can be rejected, large T and large F are mixed up. Even for cluster 2 in the ZMERGE model, which has the highest classification accuracy, large T and large F are still more almost 50-50, because the false Z's are more dominant in the full Twitter timeline than the true Z's. The purpose of this study is to obtain only documents that refer to disasters, so the purpose methods did need to be improved. In this slide, I will show you the results of an experiment focusing on the summary word set. The summary word set yields a set of words such as cluster 2. In the ZMERGE model for Typhoon Hercules deferred to the disaster, the summary word set of other clusters had few disaster-related words, so such cluster can be considered to consist of non-disaster-related documents. Cluster 2 yields a set of words related to the disaster. In summary, this slide shows the main points of my presentation. The ZMERGE model and the cluster merge model are introduced, which modify the earlier Bayesian topic model and the k-means clustering algorithm to handle the conversation threads of Twitter. The ZMERGE model shows higher classification accuracy than the other models. In the future, we will incorporate other methods to improve the accuracy of classification. That brings me to the end of my presentation. Thank you for your attention.